He's got to keep his pulse up, and you had sex with him to keep his pulse
up.
The reason why I'm uncomfortable around cats is that if you die in the house, you know, the cat will eat you.
Their animal instincts come out.
No, in fact, sometimes I don't think the cat would wait for you to die. I think if you're just in a deep sleep, the cat... If you're just taking a nap, the cat may eat you.
It's like...
They're bastards. They're ruthless. Oh, nice. Ooh. What kind of yoga?
Kundalini yoga.
I like the kundalini.
Do you? Do you know what kundalini is?
Oh, yes, I do. You've never had a yoga massage? Everybody does that now.
Oh, it's like a Thai massage?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
Thai massage is the one where they stretch you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you do that?
I have. I love massages.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who massages you then?
Random people.
Really? Good kisser.
Good kisser.
I believe.
I know.
Yeah. Is that weird kissing a girl because you're heterosexual?
I am.
Yeah.
Not really.
Like, if I had to kiss a dude because I'm heterosexual, I'd be like, oh, this is kind of awesome. No, I mean, it goes against my own personal preference sexually.
I think women are a little different.
I really hope that's true. Do you think that's really true?
Is that just a
male fantasy thing?
No, I think it's really true.
Oh, that's so awesome.
I taught a woman's class.
I didn't know you were a yoga instructor.
I got certified a few years ago.
Oh, yeah, because we talked about Kundalini. Yeah, that's right, yeah. But except we didn't call it Kundalini, did we?
No.
No. What did we call it again?
We're going to close our eyes. You're going to focus at your third eye point. And you're going... You're going to take some deep breaths, and you're going to watch your thoughts. Watch him, Craig.
It's like watching porn if I watch my phone. Please welcome Amy Smart, everybody. Amy Smart. Welcome, Amy.
Hi.
Welcome. Can I just say how lovely your hair looks?
It's nice and straight.
But Robert Downey Jr. was here, I don't know if you know this, and he was mentioning that you had...
My curlers.
Yeah, but they don't...
No, it just gives it body.
Oh, right. That's what I use.
Really? Oh, lots of body in there.
Are you mocking me? You're mocking me! You adorable monkey.
Monkey. Where's your monkey sound?
I don't have any monkey sounds anymore. I know. I got rid of all the monkeys. Fired them all. Get out. Don't awe the monkeys. They were getting ideas above their stations. Hey, is this movie about mirrors where people go through the mirrors into different times and have adventures?
No. No, it's about this guy... Kiefer Sutherland.
I recognized him.
Yeah? And there's spirits behind the mirrors, and they're possessing your reflection and causing your reflection to do horrible things.
Well, like make faces at you and stuff? Like that? let me get this straight. Now, so the spirits in the mirrors are, they're evil.
Yes.
And they go off and do get up to stuff, but it's all right because it's in mirrors, so nobody gets hurt, really.
That's not true.
Oh, gosh. Then what happens then?
Well, they possess your reflection, and your reflection does something in the mirror. And
But isn't it limited to what the reflection can actually do? I mean, given that it's stuck inside the mirror, or no? I'm missing the honest... I swear, I just...
Okay, so let me spell this out for
you. Right, okay, yeah.
So... There is spirits that are coming through on the opposite side of the glass and silver in the mirror.
Oh, they come through?
And they come through the mirrors.
Oh, Dad, no, that would be a problem right there.
Yeah.
That would be awful.
So when you see this film, it's sort of like, you know, with Jaws, when you go swimming in the ocean, now you think, oh, my God, am I going to be eaten by Jaws? It's that thing where you look in the mirror and you think, what if something happens?
The shark wasn't really called Jaws. I have a real problem with this, because people say, I'm going to be eaten by Jaws. The shark didn't have a name. It was just a shark. The movie's shark? Called Jaws. Yeah, it's just a shark. It's not like, what shark is that? Is that Bob or Jaws? No. It's Jaws is not the name of the shark. It's the name of the movie. Sorry, I had to. I couldn't let that one
go
by.
I'm glad you didn't let it go by.
I could not let it go by.
I never gave it a thought.
Yeah, I know. Do you like the horror movies? Do you go and watch them?
Not really. They scare me. And I'm like, I get really stressed out watching them. So, no, not usually.
Right. Well, so you won't go and see this movie you're
in?
No,
but I've seen this movie.
Scared?
Well, I can't be, you know, that objective because I was in it and I saw the behind the scenes. So I wasn't as scared, but it's a pretty terrifying movie.
Have you ever seen Ghost?
I think I have.
Really?
Yeah.
Where?
I was filming a movie in Las Vegas, New Mexico.
That's a different one, then.
It is a different one.
Right, okay.
Did you know it existed?
No, I didn't, but yeah. I'll pretend I did.
Yeah, okay. I was staying in this old hotel.
Right.
And there was this, in the lobby, there was this picture of this woman, and it was from, like, the early 1900s, and they said that this hotel is haunted and sometimes guests will see this woman, and I thought, okay, whatever. So 3 weeks into it, I wake up at like 4 a.m. and there's this like greenish shadow of this woman on my wall.
And shut up.
Yes. And I sort of just like froze because I didn't know if I knew what I was looking at. It was like one of those, you know, you just get paralyzed. And then I closed my eyes, turned away, and it was gone. And
had you enjoyed a herbal cigarette before bed?
Maybe.
There's areas around here haunted.
I believe.
No, this TV city's haunted.
Really?
Yeah.
What have you experienced?
There's a bathroom, haunted bathroom just upstairs.
Something
terrible happened in there. I don't know what it was. Something terrible. I don't know. Well, listen, it's lovely to see you again. Will you come back and see us again?
I would love to.
But the next movie, make it a nice movie where people aren't getting hurt.
I have another good movie coming out.
Oh, it is? What is it?
Yeah, Crank 2.
Crank 2. That's where people go nuts. And and he's got to keep his pulse up, and you had sex with him to keep his pulse up.
Yeah. I did a good job, right?
I didn't see that movie. It's lovely to see you again. Amy Smart, everybody. We'll be right back. I'm in love. Amy Smart, everybody. Amy Smart. Welcome, Amy.
Thank you, Greg.
Don't you look lovely with your top and your pants and everything?
I'm so mad I didn't have a pin to wear out here.
Well, you should wear a pin because then I could tell what mood you had.
I should have a snake pin like
that. Oh, you like this cup? Look at that cup, baby. Look at that one. Eh? Oh, yeah.
What is
that?
Daddy's
got a big old rattlesnake cup.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
Oh, sorry.
Spits.
It does spit. It's a rattlesnake.
I know.
It's from the Albuquerque Rattlesnake Museum. See, a guest brought me a gift. Yeah, some of them bring gifts. Oh, yeah.
I am so sorry. Next time.
That's all right. I like this one.
I like that.
Do you like snakes?
No. They scare me.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, didn't you?
I like a lot of creatures, but snakes freak me out.
All right, well, let's go favorite creature, least favorite creature, right? Favorite creature, panda, I'm guessing.
Why would you guess a panda?
Well, because they're adorable, cuddly, eat bamboo,
are
vegetarians.
They?
Yeah. Panda? You quite like pandas, admit
I've never met a panda.
Neither have I.
I like dogs and cats and animals I can cuddle with.
Oh, all right, well, you can cuddle a panda. It'll be the last cuddle of your life. It'll be more than that.
Oh, really?
Did you see that woman that jumped into the polar bear thing in Germany? Did you see that?
No, I didn't.
Oh, it was horrible. See, at feeding time, this woman jumps over into this polar bear enclosure. I'm like, they're eating. Yeah. They're not cuddly. All right, so you like dogs and cats, and you don't like snakes.
I like them from a distance. I just don't understand them. I'm scared they're gonna bite me. I'm sorry.
Well, they might bite you.
They might.
They might. So
look at those
best
fangs.
To keep a distance. Well, that won't bite you. That's a piece of
clay.
Pottery. Yeah, it's It's clay fashioned into a, you know, a representation of a snake, but actually it's hollowed out and there's a beverage inside. Look at that.
What are you drinking?
Something fizzy. Do you enjoy champagne?
I do.
Do you really? I never liked champagne when I was drinking.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I like a little champagne every once in a while to celebrate.
I liked champagne.
What the hell is that?
Champagne is very inexpensive champagne.
That's hot.
It's like $2 chuck. Yeah, it's fantastic.
Champagne.
Bottle of champagne, living the dream. Sun's out, guns out. Yeah.
That's nice. Yeah. I'll have to try some.
Go ahead. Try the champagne.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, good. Well, how are you? How's the movie then?
It's crazy.
Yeah. The Legend of Curly's Gold. Is that it?
No, it's not.
All right.
No, Crank 2 is crazier than the first one.
All right. That was crazy.
It was.
Well, I'm not making fun. I'm not.
Yeah, the second one has some interesting scenes in it.
Oh, well, that's good. You want that in a movie. Yeah, for sure. Do you like to go and see the movies yourself? Do you go and see the action movies or the horror movies, perhaps? Or something with zombies?
I'm usually not a huge fan of the horror movies. They scare me. But
they're meant to.
I know they are. So usually I avoid those. But I do like some action films, and I like the more dramatic films.
I know the type you like. The English dramas where everyone's... all that.
I like some of those.
The Merchant Ivory films. Everyone's, yeah, Sir Ghastly, what do you think he's saying? I don't know. What do you think he's saying? I don't know. I've got the vapors. And then...
The vapors.
Yeah, the vapors. I sometimes get them.
Do you?
Yeah, but not from me. From my dog. I've got a new dog. It's very farty.
Stinky?
Do you have dogs?
I do. They fart.
Oh, my God. What kind of dogs do you have?
I have a Wheaton Terrier.
What kind of...
He's 40 pounds. His name's Oscar, and he looks like a bear. He's just so cuddly and delicious.
Oh, that's good. So you cut little bits off of him and eat them?
I do. I'm like, here.
Oh, tasty.
And so, then two cats as well.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't have you down as a cat lady. What's the, what kind of cats?
The cat lady. Uh-oh, I'm pegged.
No. Well, I always have had a theory. I've said this on the show before a couple of times, that I think the reason why I'm uncomfortable around cats is that if you die in the house, you know, the cat will eat you.
Instincts come out.
No, in fact, sometimes I don't think the cat would wait for you to die. I think if you're just in a deep sleep, the cat... If you're just taking a nap, the cat may eat you.
It's like...
They're bastards. They're ruthless. Yeah, you better feed those cats. Keep them fat. It's your only chance of life.
You've never had a cat, have you?
I did have a cat once.
Did it eat you? Did you wake up to it, like, biting your leg?
No. It wasn't... No, not the cat, but the, do that thing where you did that thing in my leg.
You like that?
Awesome. I used to live in an apartment, and it was a sublet, and there was a cat in it. I had to take care of the cat. His name was Ken, and he was a bastard. And I've written about it all in my new book.
Have you? All about Ken.
No way. No way am I writing a book about that. No, there's maybe a chapter about Ken, and that's it. Moving on. Where are you? You should write a book.
I should?
Yeah, why not?
What would you like me to write about?
A book about your favorite animals and how to avoid snakes and stuff.
Maybe I will.
Maybe you will.
Maybe I will.
Well, come back and see you soon. It's been too long since the last time.
Okay, enjoy this movie. It's insane.
It is. It's very good. The Crank 2.
Yeah.
High voltage. Amy Smart, everybody. Remember that.
To bring you a gift, and this reminded me of you.
Why did you bring this?
Because we were talking about animals last time.
Uh-huh.
And that you love dogs.
This is a dog?
It's a dog, look. Hi.
Oh, yes. It's a lovely dog. It's a sort of very tall dog. Thank you for this.
You're welcome.
I'll just put it over here where it can't damage a camera. You just look sensational. Look at you.
Thank
My
you.
God, you're gorgeous. Is that a cape?
It looks like one, doesn't it? I feel like a superhero.
Yeah. You should wear your underpants over the top of it.
Wonder Woman, yeah, baby.
No. Did Wonder Woman wear her underpants over her pants?
She just had the gold.
She was used to that, and she had an invisible plane, Wonder Woman, which I always thought was weird, because she wasn't invisible. So she'd be just, like, sitting in her invisible plane, and then you go, oh, look, there's Wonder Woman.
Right.
She just
was Wonder Woman.
I know, I'm sorry. I'm picking holes in an otherwise airtight plot. Tell me... Tell me about the dance movie. Do you guys fall in love in that movie?
We do.
Oh.
I play a school teacher at a middle school, and this guy who's a 2-time world champion West Coast swing dancer comes to the school and does this whole assembly, and my character gets really inspired and decides to take dance lessons with this teacher. And he's not gay.
Okay, so they're right there. You're off you go to into science fiction right there, yeah.
My favorite movie is Dirty Dancing, and that is not science fiction.
I've never sat all the way through that movie.
How could you not?
I don't know.
You don't like it?
No, I liked the bits that I've seen, but I had other stuff to do.
It got you aroused or something?
Yeah.
Oh.
Really?
What?
It gets you aroused, Dirty Dancing?
Well, I saw it when I was like 12, so...
Yes, girls who were about that age when Dirty Dancing came out really liked that kind of movie.
Yeah, I practiced a lot.
You, yeah.
I wanted to be in that movie.
I was in Flashdance.
Were you? Do you have something I can see of it?
Yeah.
Do you have some moves?
I can show you a clip from the movie.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do we have that old clip of me in Flashdance? Do we have it? Do we? No. Oh, yeah, there it is. Look, there it
is. Look at that.
Yeah. Yeah. You probably won't feel about that. Yeah.
Wow.
I just want you to know, for no reason, I'd just like you to know I've been working out a lot since that movie, and I've, you know, been watching what I eat and dieting and stuff. That's not me anymore.
Really? So how much weight have you lost?
A pound. Do you ever have a problem?
You're all toned up.
Yeah, now, do you work out and do all that stuff? You're in fantastic shape.
I do sometimes.
What do you do?
I do yoga.
Oh, nice.
Ooh.
What kind of yoga?
Kundalini yoga.
I like the kundalini.
Do you? Do you know what kundalini is?
Oh, yes, I do.
Wow.
I do. Kundalini is the one you do for a very long time, isn't it?
It is.
You hold the pose in kundalini for a very long time.
You always
have to go longer than you think you're going to have to go with the old kundalini.
And you do breath of fire.
Breath of fire, yeah, I do that.
You do?
Not always with... No, never mind. I broke a camera earlier on. Did you see that?
Yeah, I saw that.
Do you know why I did that?
Because
I don't know my own strength.
Really?
Yeah, I can do a push-up.
Go ahead.
No, not now. I've done one today. That's it. Yeah. Do you ever do the hot yoga? Or do you ever do the
Bikram yoga?
Yeah, the Bikram. That's what I meant. Yeah.
Yeah. I have.
Did you like it?
I did Bikram for about 4 months a long time ago, and it was the most flexible I ever got, which is great. But
that's not bad. I'm sitting here thinking about it.
Are you?
Not in a creepy way. Then yes, in a creepy way. No.
But I'm not a fan of it because you know, everybody just sweats so hard in that yoga and drips, and it just feels kind of dirty in the classroom. Does that sound good to you?
Yeah.
It does.
Yeah, it does. It sounds kind of great
like
to me.
I,
is that so wrong? Do you do the?
It's not.
Do you do the yoga lifestyle? Do you like have fresh yogurt or whatever it is? Are you vegetarian? Do you do that?
I am not, but I eat a lot of vegetarian food.
Yeah, but it doesn't make you a vegetarian because you eat a lot of vegetables. It just makes you someone that enjoys vegetables with your steak. Can I have some bacon and sprouts, please?
No, I was for a long time, and I started eating some meat again, and I don't know. We'll see. That's about it, Craig.
Yeah, well. All right, well, thanks for dropping by, Amy. It's always now. Congratulations on, you know, becoming a yoga instructor. You could probably come back, and you could do a yoga demonstration for us.
I could.
Yeah.
I'm certified.
When you're certified, no, we couldn't.
Not before.
No, not before. Because, you know, something could break or... And then when you come back, what we'll do is we'll make a yoga set and we'll put this on it. And it can watch you doing yoga. And when you're doing your yoga, it can go like this. And we'll put a tiny little camera in there.
Oh, I like the idea of the camera.
Yeah, you put a camera in the dog and just watch things. We're way over time and he's getting really mad, but not as mad as he is about the broken camera. We have to go, Amy. We'll see you next time.
Yeah.
All right. Amy Smart, everybody. We'll be right back. Please welcome Amy Smart, everybody. Seen you in ages.
I know.
You look lovely in your orange dress.
Thank you.
I like the way that it's cut sort of square here to sort of imply there's an area.
There's an area?
There's an area that...
Cut out. Suggestive.
Yeah. It's nice that... Is that... Can I touch?
Go ahead.
We used to have a couch like that when I was a kid. I mean, seriously, it was that material. It's kind of 70s-y material.
Yeah, it kind of got chic after a while.
Did it?
Yeah.
I've got a whole mess of couch material I can sell.
That is so eco-friendly of you.
I don't know where it is. And also, I don't know if you'd want to wear anything that I used to use as a couch,
yeah,
especially before I got sober. You know what I'm saying?
It's a bit... A lot of spots on the couch.
Hey!
Nasty.
A little bit. This show looks awesome.
It's really fun. It's very raunchy.
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah.
And the people are smoking and drinking. No one does that anymore.
Not in America.
Well, they do it in America, but they don't do it in L.A., which is not America.
Yeah. It is sobriety city here.
Yeah, a little bit. Are you okay with your chronic drinking problem, you over?
Absolutely.
All right, that's good. Yeah, you're accepting it now. Where are you from? I forget.
I'm from here, L.A.
L.A., that's right. I forgot that.
Topanga Canyon.
Topanga?
Yeah.
That's right, because it's the hippie canyon you're from.
Yes.
It's lovely. You probably know Matthew from Bongos and Paw.
I've seen him on the beach before.
Really? Are you a beach girl?
Kind of.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you do there?
Get tan.
Do you wear a little outfit?
A little bikini.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Good for you.
Thanks.
That's what I wear as well. Oh, I forgot you're frightened of the snake,
Wait,
aren't you?
Wait, I don't know if I want to see you in a bikini.
Why not?
You don't have boobs.
Yes, I do.
Do you?
No, but it's threatening. I've come to that point where I'm like, oh, God, I'm going to have to do something or else.
Really?
Yeah, completely.
Stop drinking soy.
Drinking soy?
Yeah.
Ooh, that's what happens if you drink a lot of that, right?
Yeah.
I thought it was tofu, but tofu's fine. It's
the soy.
Same
thing, it's soy.
Tofu gives you breasts?
They could. What? Cut out.
What, if you, like, mash them up and put them into a bra?
No, tofu's made from soy.
Is it?
Soy.
I didn't know that. You really are from Topanga. Are you a vegetarian?
No.
Well, how come you know all about vegetables then? You don't like the snake, do you?
I don't like snakes at all. They scare me.
Yeah, it's not a real snake.
Just water or what?
No, it's soy milk.
Growing your boobs for the summer.
Get my beach body ready. Do girls do that then? Do girls drink a lot of soy and tofu and stuff so that their boobies will grow?
Some do.
Really? Name names. Who?
I don't know.
Who in Hollywood? Who in Hollywood amongst your Hollywood actress friends? Do you hang about with a lot of actresses?
Not really.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you do then when you're not making sexy programs?
I actually work with the Environmental Media Association. I do a lot of environmental work. And with Heal the Bay.
Great.
I do that kind of thing.
Yeah, it's awesome.
Cheers. I do work with organic gardens.
Do you really?
Uh-huh.
Do you grow your own vegetables?
Mm-hmm.
Do you grow marrows?
What?
Marrows, these big giant penis-y shaped vegetables. You've never seen a marrow? Maybe I've got an old country name for it. Marrow. It's a big thing. It's like a
It's a squash.
Like, it's like a squash, okay. But it's more penisy.
Are they good?
Penises or marrows?
Marrows.
Marrows are great.
They
penises,
are.
Penises, I have not got that much experience.
You haven't?
With. Well, I've got one.
Not even with the crab fisherman.
The crab fisherman that came on the boat. Yeah.
Yeah. Dirty. Yeah, and what's the vibrator back there for?
Oh, that's a personal massager. When I you can borrow it if you want. It's just, you know, when you have problem areas. You know when you go to these the stores like what was that, Sharper Image, and
yeah.
you can say you can buy a personal massager.
Yeah.
It just looks like a giant thing.
It does.
And then did you ever go and sit on the massage chair?
Yeah.
And it's just like sitting on an airplane with a kid behind you.
With a kid. Rolling you?
Yeah, just going, eh,
kicking
yeah.
you.
That do you is go true. For massages? Do you?
I do. I love them.
Really? What kind do you like? Kundalini? Oh, that's yoga, isn't
that's
it?
That's yoga.
Yeah, would you ever have a yoga? You've never had a yoga massage? Everybody does that now.
Oh, it's like a Thai massage?
Sure, why not?
Okay.
Thai massage is the one where they stretch you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you do that?
I have. I love it, massages.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Who massages you then?
Random people.
Really? You just gonna go, I want a massage from you, and then they come over?
I usually go to a spa or someplace.
Really?
Yeah.
So you get covered in mud?
I have.
Have you done that? I sat
yeah.
once in a bath with a dung in it.
With a what?
Dung, you know, animal dung. They said it was mud, but it was poo. It was like animal. It smelled like poo.
It did?
Yeah. It was this place out near Palm Springs, and they said, oh, you sit in here, and all the essential oils are there, and it pulls all the toxins out. And this is a bath full of...
What's the coming to go?
Maybe a lot of people
Crikey.
In the bath.
Well, you know, you could easily, you know, let one go in there. No one would know, because...
Probably a lot of people have.
I think they probably do. You're relaxing and they're warm and they're just, oh, yes. Is that where you go? You go to spas out there and get yourself...
I've been to the mud baths, and but I just like a regular Swedish massage, reflexology, all that stuff.
You really are from here, aren't you?
I am.
Yeah.
I'll send you some soy products.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I'll grow a pair of breasts in
get
my
a
garden.
Spray tan, and you could eat your lawn.
Would you ever spray tan? I mean, you're quite, you know, you're a pale person.
Thank you.
Well, no, that's a compliment. It is a compliment.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, pale, you know, sort of pale and interesting. That's good.
Pale and interesting?
Yeah, well, you're not orange in Jersey Shore. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
that
yeah,
bad.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
I mean, like, the Jersey Shore girls are the color of your damn dress. I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's nice to see someone with natural colored skin, hair, teeth, eyes, and their own breasts for a change.
My breasts are real.
Are they now? How
they
can
are.
We be sure?
I don't know. I'd be bigger if I wasn't. No. Hi.
Awkward pause or mouth organ? We're out of time.
Mouth organ.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Go for it.
It's that same dude, he's been here all night. He just makes me feel worse. He's trying to help by laughing, and it's just making me feel worse and worse and worse. He's like, ah, ha, ha. Like, dude, it's not even the point. It's all right, well, here you are, then. Can you play? I'd love you to win the golden mouth organ if you could.
No, are we going to play together? Wait, hold on. What are you talking about?
The mouth organ, the harmonica. The mouth organ's another way of saying it, you know?
Okay.
Put it in your mouth. Low, backwards, and forwards, that kind of thing.
Wait, am I really playing this with you?
I don't know. Have you? Can you play it?
No.
Well, then it's going to be awkward, isn't it?
Yes. Oh, you're really good at it.
Yeah, I know. Listen to that. You can't play, but I like watching you try.
I'm taking this home and practicing.
You can take it home. It's yours. It's free and for nothing.
Thanks.
We get given them, don't we?
Good
by five? A company called Harmonica.
All right, we're out of time.
Okay.
You want to throw to a commercial break. Go, here's the commercials, and then go like that.
Here's the commercial.
Great, Amy, you look great, and I really particularly enjoyed that clip you brought. That's fantastic.
Do you like it?
I don't know if it really happened. I'm on a lot of cold medication right now. That's why I didn't grope you desperately when you walked out.
That's okay.
Is it?
Yeah.
I thought you rather looked forward to that. You've been here a lot of times. I thought that's why you kept coming back, so that I could go, hi, Amy, I'm back.
Do you want to do that now?
Yeah, but I can't. You'll get sick.
Oh, well.
And I'll get fired. Anyway, I haven't seen you since you got married. Congratulations.
I know,
thank you. Let me see what's going on.
I got a little bling on there.
Holy crackers, look at that thing.
I'm sure you did pretty well for your wife, too.
I did.
Five months ago.
Five months? That's in Hollywood terms, that's the golden wedding, I think.
Oh, my God. It's so disappointing to see all these celebrities getting divorced.
I don't care. Who's getting divorced in celebrity world? Oh, Seal and Heidi.
7 years? Oh. Yeah, I don't know. I think it's disappointing. I think what they say, like 80% of all celebrities get divorced.
No, I think that's... is that true?
Yeah. Scares me.
You just made that up.
No, I swear.
But who does that survey? Who can I go, hi, I'm doing a survey on celebrities. Are you getting divorced? How do you back that up? It's like a made-up thing.
No, it's not.
It's when a real thing?
I swear to God, when I was meeting with business managers, they were like, look, 4 out of every 5 celebrity couples get divorced.
Are you a celebrity couple? Is your husband a celebrity?
Yeah.
Oh, I see. Well, enjoy it while it lasts.
I'm going to be the 20%.
That's right.
Okay,
you're
going to
be the 20%, and it's going to be great and awesome. And where did you guys, where did you go on honeymoon?
We went to Big Sur. We drove up. Have you been?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Yeah.
It's pretty there, isn't it?
Beautiful there, yeah.
I stayed at
a place there called the Post Ranch Inn.
That's where I stayed.
You know they don't allow kids?
Really?
I'd love to go back.
They don't like
little kids in there. It's kind of like, you know, in Chitty Chitty Bang Bang where the child catcher, that thing?
They just scoop them out.
They catch them and they take them away.
You can't sneak them in?
No.
Can I tell you where I took my husband when we were up there?
Where?
To Esalen Institute. Have you heard of it?
No, what is that?
They have natural hot springs.
Oh.
You have to go naked. It's like naked hot springs.
You let your husband see you naked? I guess you know what you're doing.
It's really cool, though.
Is that the one where you sit in the mud and everything?
No, it's just like these natural hot springs.
Hot, bubbly, gassy water.
Yeah, it smells like eggs.
I tell you what I did do that, is when I was in Sicily back in the day, in the foothills of Mount Etna, they have these little pools full of sulfurous, gassy, and I got in there, and I smelled like rotten eggs for about 2 years.
2 years? Really, like, did you drink it all?
I drank everything I could get my hands on in those days. Sulfur hot springs, anything. You ever been to Sicily?
No.
You should go. It's fantastic. I went to a place called Cefalù, tiny little town. They don't allow kids. I'd love to go back. No, they have kids there. They're Italian. They love kids. They're like, yeah, oh, bring all the kids over here.
Here's some wine.
Sit down. Give them some wine. Shut up.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's good. That's nice. Big Sur, eh?
Yeah.
What else is going on? You were kissing Emmy Rossum there. Is that Emmy Rossum you were kissing?
That is Emmy Rossum.
She's nice. She hasn't been here in years. Why hasn't Emmy been here? I'm just thinking that when I saw her kissing Amy in that clip. Emmy,
She'll come on.
Yeah.
She's pretty great.
Yeah, she's nice. Good kisser,
I believe. I know.
Yeah. Is that weird kissing a girl because you're heterosexual?
I am.
Yeah.
Not really.
Like, if I had to kiss a dude because I'm heterosexual, I'd be like, oh, this is kind of awesome. No, I mean, it goes against my own personal preference sexually.
I think women are a little different.
I really hope that's true. Do you think that's really true?
Is that just a
male fantasy thing?
No, I think it's really true.
Oh, that's so awesome. I'm so
relieved. Isn't that great? Lesbian Rose like, well, I don't know about. Oh, hey, have you ever been to Sweden?
No.
Oh, you'd love it.
I would.
You'd fit right in Sweden. Hey, have you ever been to Trondheim?
No.
Because that's in Norway. Have you ever heard aha?
Uh-huh.
That's good. You really cheered me up with that news about girls.
I think it's true.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm kind of surprised. I thought it was just kind of a construct of male fantasy that actually, you know, heterosexuals, male and female, were one way, and people who were homosexual, male and female, were another way, and that's just the way it was. It's not like that.
I think there's the gray area.
I'm sorry, I'm on a lot of medication. Is this really happening? This might be the greatest show of my life.
Your chances are coming true.
I'm almost expecting to ride a unicorn to Cake Mountain.
I wish a unicorn would come out right now.
You know, I wish a unicorn would come out right now, too, but I think there's only a... Who's that at the door? What do you find? You wanna go for a mouth organ? You want the big cash prize or awkward pause? Would you?
Awkward pause.
Oh really? I'm thinking about girls kissing.
I'm thinking about guys kissing.
Really? I mean, look, it's cool. I love all the people. No, hey, I'm totally there, but, I mean, really? Like, let me just ask you very quickly during this awkward pause that I've dismissed. Like, it's not the same for heterosexual... Like, heterosexual men, when they see two women kissing, are like, oh, man, that's awesome.
Hot.
But heterosexual women, when seeing two men kissing, would not feel the same way, or would she?
I wouldn't be turned on, but I think it's kind of cute. I don't know if that's good or not.
Alice is just great. Great. What a great show, and I'm so glad you've been part of it.
Thanks, Greg.
We have to stop talking now. Which seems a shame, really. Answer a question honestly, all right?
Okay.
Am I creepy? Yeah, a little bit. I think I have my answer. Amy Grant, everyone! Welcome back, everybody. That's enough. My next guest is a beautiful and talented actress. She's a very nice girl.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Please welcome the lovely Amy Smart, everybody. Amy Smart.
Thank you.
Now, listen, I don't want to scare you, but when I hugged you there,
I
was kind of like happy and breathing in, and some of your hair went in my throat. And I was like, so you might want to check your hair for phlegm.
Right.
I was like, oh, should I mention this? Because people will slow it down at home and you'll see.
Wow. That's
how are you? Your hair
great.
Looks great, by the way.
Well,
apart from the snot bit. How are they?
everything's going. You look great. You
Thank
look lovely.
You. Thank you.
Have you got a tan? Have you been away somewhere?
I was away all summer in northern Michigan.
That's where you go if you love to get a tan. What were you doing in northern Michigan?
We just decided my husband bought a farmhouse up there years ago.
Fantastic.
It's so beautiful.
Do you have chickens?
No.
Then it's not a farm, lady.
I know. We have some really great barns, and then we have this old pole barn that used to have...
A pole barn, you say?
Yeah. We could have some good pole barnies there.
You have no animals at all?
Well, we brought our dog and cat.
Wow, that's a real working ranch you got there.
Yep, flew my cat up.
Flew your cat?
I did.
Wow. It's like, yeah,
It's like, woo!
That's a big cat.
That was
what kind of a cat. What kind of a cat have you got there?
It's just a little black short-haired cat.
Oh, yeah, what kind of dog?
Bulldog.
English bulldog or French bulldog?
English.
Oh, okay.
His name is Slim.
Is that ironic?
It is. He's actually really fit.
Right. It's all right. Why in Michigan, though? Is your husband from there?
Yeah, he's from there.
Ah, right. So yeah. The in-laws are around and everything.
Yes, and my parents live there now, so...
Your parents live near your husband's parents?
Yes.
What the hell is this?
It's sick. I know.
Wait, did that just happen? They were like, oh, that looks nice. We'll go and live next to them?
No, they moved up there, like, almost 20 years ago.
So, was that how you met your husband then? You were there?
No, I met him in L.A.
That's weird.
I know.
Did you guys go, I can't believe my parents are in Northern... Let's get married.
Basically. Yeah.
But you're a California girl. I always think of you as, like, the quintessential California Topanga, walking around.
Hippie
with, you know, beads and drugs. You're not that druggy, though, are you?
No, I'm not really. I'm not.
Right, okay.
Not really.
No, I don't think of you as that. I think of you as being a very kind of earthy, sunshine, flowers in your hair.
I was teaching yoga up there.
You were teaching yoga?
I was. I taught a woman's class.
I didn't know you were a yoga instructor.
I got certified a few years ago.
Oh, yeah, because we talked about Kundalini
yoga.
Yeah, that's right, yeah. But except we didn't call it Kundalini, did we?
No.
No. What did we call it again?
What did you call it? You had the little dirty name for it.
I think you get the wrong guy. I might have called it Cunnilingus yoga.
Yeah. By the way, you and my mom.
Your mom called it that?
Yes.
But on purpose?
No, kind of. I mean, I taught...
What kind of yoga are you teaching up there?
I swear it's just Kundalini.
Right.
She was at my first class, and my mom's like, I can't really pronounce it. It sounds like Kundalingus. I just can't. She, like, melds the two.
You know, that's a workout video I think would sell. Just saying.
You think so?
I do.
I'll burn lots of candles.
Yeah. Be careful with the candles.
Bring a couple.
You know, do you hear about that scented candle shop in Texas?
Yes.
It was a brothel or something.
I could have easily walked into that.
Are you big on scented candles?
I love candles.
I do like a scented candle myself, I have to say. That's not code. I actually do like scented candles.
What kind of scents do you like?
Well, you know, biscuit smells.
Really? Yeah. Like baked cookies?
Yeah, if you got it. Do you have any baked cookie candles in your store?
I've got some vanilla. I don't have a store, but if I did.
Why don't you? Look, if you're teaching Kundalingus yoga to the ladies up there in Michigan, then you might as well take them some scented candles. It gets cold up there in the winter.
One of the ladies gave me a scented candle as a thank you gift.
What smell was it?
Lemongrass?
That's code.
It was...
Yeah.
For what?
I'm lesbian attracted to you. That was just a thing I was saying. That's not what I wasn't... I was just saying that.
Are you a lesbian?
No, of course not. I'm a gentleman.
Oh, okay.
Is your husband a gentleman?
He's very much a gentleman.
Right. Here's how you can tell. Because I had this argument with my wife the other night.
Okay.
And she said, you know, we've been married for nearly 5 years. You can knock off the courtesy flush when you go to the bathroom. I'm like, what are you talking about? He said, you know, the flush that you do so that I can't hear what you're doing. And I'm like,
The courtesy flush is the mark of a gentleman, is what I said.
Oh.
Does your husband do the courtesy flush?
Sometimes.
Have a listen. Sometimes. If you guys are not arguing.
Right. If he likes me that day.
Oh, he likes you every day. You're adorable. How could he not like you?
Oh, so, thanks.
Yeah.
How's that horse in the corner?
Well, it's not a real horse.
Does it talk?
No, he doesn't talk, but he communicates in many ways. He's been listening to a lot of early Snoop.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so he thinks he's a bit gangster right now. See, look there. Yeah.
All right. Oh, I like
all right,
that.
All right, mind on your money, money on your money.
I kind of want to see... I kind of want to see that Snoop dance.
Well, we're out of time, actually. Do you want to go and do the Snoop dance with the horse to get done here?
Okay.
Do you want to?
If you come with me.
Oh, all right. We'll be right back. Come on out. Let's go.
The beautiful Amy Smart, everybody. Amy Smart.
Wow.
Thank you.
Wow, Amy.
Hi.
I mean, wow.
Hi.
Jeez. Wow, look at you. You look amazing.
Thank you. I wanted to sparkle for you.
Well, you for me?
Yes.
I can't possibly accept, but I'd love to. It's very sparkly.
Okay.
Is that vintage?
It's not. It's made to look vintage, though.
Well, you know what? It's very authentic looking.
Thank you. I'm gonna go with that.
Yeah, it looks amazing. And good shoes, nice
Thank
choice,
you.
Open toe.
I like your socks.
Thanks. I wore them the night Ashton Kutcher was here as well. Did you?
You don't do laundry very much.
Yeah,
no.
Well, you know, I cleaned them after he was. Yeah, because you were meant to be here that night, remember? And
I
then
know.
I limboed, and then you were really mad at me, and you slapped me really hard and pulled my hair. Nice. I'm sorry. I'm going way too far with
you. Healed.
What?
The red spot's gone.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
Are you mad at me? A little bit.
You know, you picked Ashton over me. I'm a little
jealous. No. I did not pick him over you. He just got talking and I got lost in his eyes. They're dreamy.
I see which way you sway now.
Yeah. No, you don't. Yeah. How are things with you? How are things with, where is it you live again? Topanga, isn't it?
I grew up in Topanga.
Yeah.
Anymore,
How are things? You eat a lot of kale out there, don't you?
I do eat a lot of kale. Do you eat a lot of kale? It's good for you.
I think I eat. My wife puts this weird green substance near the food and makes me eat it. I'm guessing that's what it is.
Does she ever put it in a smoothie?
I don't have smoothies.
You don't?
No.
It's a good place to hide.
No, I don't like smoothies.
Why?
They're un-American. I don't know why. I used to drink smoothies, but aren't they like millions of calories and you don't know what's going in? There's like...
If you put like a lot of ice cream in it or something, but no.
Well, that's the only way I would want to have one, though. Take away the taste of the kale. Do you eat... You clearly don't have a lot of high calorie...
I eat everything, but I do smoothies because you could put like a lot of frozen fruit, hide the kale.
Right.
Because, you know...
It's not that nice.
It's okay, but, you know...
Yeah, it tastes like...
It's good for you, but
it tastes like
groggy.
Yeah, I know. It does. I think it does. I'm allowed to say that. It's America. I can say... I can't say that? You're a racist, man. Are you still at the bendy and stretchy?
Yeah. I actually took a level 2 yoga teacher's training this weekend.
And? Did you pass?
And it's reminded... Well, it's three weekends in a row, so
All right.
I still have 2 more weekends to go, but it was for mind and meditation.
meditative yoga?
It was, well, there is, you know, in yoga, you do yoga to help meditate.
Well, yoga means union, doesn't it?
Mind
and
does.
Yeah, so.
So, and then it helps your mind.
Right. Are you suggesting I need to do some?
It could help.
Okay, I'll do some. You want to? I've got meditate music here. Watch this. See, there, that helps you meditate, doesn't it?
That's the face you make.
Sorry, I was doing
he looks
something else.
So relaxed.
Yeah, that.
He looks
well,
like
okay,
you're going
let's
to the
take
bathroom.
Me through some meditation then. Let's do some.
Okay.
All right, you're a teacher. Go.
Well, I can't cross my leg. I mean, I can't go in cross-legged position.
Okay, we'll let that slide.
All right. So you could put your hands on your lap.
All right.
Touch your thumbs to your index fingers.
Okay.
It's called Gyan Mudra.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're gonna close your eyes. You're gonna focus at your third eye point. And you're going. You're gonna take some deep breaths and you're gonna watch your thoughts. Watch them, Craig.
It's like watching porn if I watch my phone.
Okay.
Right. Okay, I'm watching them.
Are they still coming?
Yeah. The horse is doing it too. Isn't that cute? Look. And Jeff. Jeff's doing it too. Look, he's turned his eyes out. All right, come on. What's next?
Okay.
When's the tickly bit? Is that, that's
no, we don't. We don't do the tickle bit.
That's it. Then you just do that for a while.
For a while.
I really like that movie you did.
Thank you.
The Single Moms Club.
Yeah,
and
thank
now,
you.
But it's about. What's it about? The Single
well,
Moms Club.
I don't know.
I can't think.
Maybe single moms.
And it's all about single moms.
It
go,
is.
They go it's crazy about, on a crime spree.
That would be pretty interesting.
Yes.
No.
Oh.
It's basically about these five moms that come together. Their kids all go to private school. They're about to be expelled because the kids are all acted up and were bad. So the moms have to come together and throw a fundraiser at the school. And every mom happens to be single. And they form the Single Moms Club, and they become really supportive and start dating.
Yeah. When's the robot coming in, or the killer, or the you know, when do people start?
There's lovers that come in.
Okay, right? That's good. Yeah,
it's
now.
Comedy. It's not a.
It's a comedy. It's a comedy.
It's a comedy.
It's a comedy that women would enjoy.
And men.
Sure.
A lot of fun men in there too. Men.
Yeah.
You gotta take your wife to see this.
You bet I will.
Good.
She'll be like, no, I want to see RoboCop. I'm like, get in the car, bitch. We're going to see Single Moms Club.
Hell yeah.
Yeah. We have to take a break.
Okay.
From each other.
Fine, I'll have a sip from this mug.
Okay, I'll have a sip from this bigger, more flamboyant mug. We'll be right back with Amy Smart. We're on. Welcome back, everybody. I'm talking to Amy Smart about Single Moms Club. She got a little mad at me because she thought I was a little bit disrespectful about the movie, but I wasn't. It's a great movie.
Yeah.
It's funny.
It's totally
it's
funny.
It's got really funny, sexually attractive women in it. That works for me.
Oh, good. Then go
I
see
find
it.
Funny women very sexually attractive.
You do?
I do. I'm very attracted to a sense of humor.
So which women?
Let's see. Julia Louis-Dreyfus, very funny,
yep.
Very attractive. Lucille Ball. Hot as hell. No, really. I mean, Lucille Ball, you know, she was like 6 foot tall, redhead, funny, smoking hot body. I mean, obviously it was a while ago, but still, you know.
Right.
Yeah.
That's a good one to call on.
Why?
Because she's dead. I mean.
Because she's
I mean, because
dead?
She's dead to you.
But she's dead to everybody, God bless her.
But she's not even an option.
Why do you hate Lucille so much, Amy?
She's so funny.
No, she was
amazing. She was amazing.
Yeah, she was amazing.
Yeah.
Are you attracted to men with a sense of humor? Or do
absolutely.
You like the, see, women always say that.
No.
Then,
no, I mean it.
Yeah, you do?
I do.
Yeah.
It's what kind one of says? The best. Well, I'm not going to start naming people, though.
Well, you made me do it.
I know, but I'm not going to do it.
Well, I'm not going to do it either once the edit comes in.
Okay, fine. Oh, snap.
Yeah.
So we're also starting a winery, my husband and I.
You're starting a winery?
We are.
Are you an alcoholic?
No, that's why we're starting.
That's why you can start a winery. Yeah, of course. What are you going? Yeah. You're going to sell wine?
Yeah.
To hobos or fancy folks?
Hopefully, a little of everything.
Okay, that's good. So you're making low-grade, super high alcoholic content wine to sell to vagrants. That's
high grade. No.
No, you're making nice wine.
No, we're making nice wine.
Where's your vineyard?
It's in Traverse City, Michigan.
Michigan, the home of wine.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
Michigan wine is some of the best in the world.
Don't laugh.
It's enough.
Okay.
Yeah, all right, we got to stop.
But it's... Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Never mind.
So you...
It's called Bonobo. And I want you to research that.
It's a monkey's name.
It is. Oh, you know.
I do. It's a nice, gentle monkey.
They are lovers, not fighters.
Right. Yeah, they're gentle monkeys. They have sex a lot.
They do.
Yeah.
It's your new favorite monkey, isn't it?
It's always been my favorite monkey. We gotta go.
Fine, bye.
All right. Amy Smart, everybody. Bye.